Hi guys, this is Bill. I got another exciting recipe for you. You know, I'm always trying to think, holidays are coming, and what can you do that's kind of cool? So this is a meal that actually I started making several years ago, and it's kind of dual purpose. Like, you can use it like hors d'oeuvres, little frilly toothpicks, or you can actually make it as a dinner, serve it on some rice, but it's my version of a sweet and sour meatball. So the first thing is you want to get the right kind of beef. So obviously I shop at Wassey's, link down below to show you where they are if you happen to be in the area. Because we don't want, you know, the mystery meat kind of stuff. We want good meat. So for lower fat content, I actually got a pound of ground round, and then I took and I really minced up some onion. My mom used to have this little glass, looked like a mason jar with a piece of wood for like a cutting board in the bottom. You screw the top on it, and that I think that's how my mom used to do it. But that thing's long gone. If you really aren't really great artistry with a knife, you can always use a food processor or whatever. But we want a quarter cup, so it's not a whole lot. And then you actually have to put a teaspoon of salt in here. And we just want to shape these into little like 1-inch balls. And I think this is pretty hot. So I'll just have a little bit of oil in here to get things started. I'm just going to start putting these in here. And this is just a single recipe. Obviously, if you're having a big party, you know, back in the day, we used to have electric skillets, then they started to be called electric Dutch ovens. Got a lot of surface area. That's how I actually learned to do this recipe. Either way, just want to get some of these. And this is actually kind of a trial run. So I'm going to eat this as a meal for dinner tonight to make sure it's really what I want for an upcoming event. And they don't have to be perfect, especially if you're eating them. You know, if you're serving to people, you can try. Of course, my grandfather always used to say, if you're not sure how the meal's going to turn out, just make sure they have a lot of wine to drink beforehand. Then every party's great. So I don't know if you've ever cooked meatballs like this before. We just want to give them a chance to really get a nice hard shell on the one side. Because we want these cooked through. I mean, they're going to, if you're doing these in hors d'oeuvre, obviously, they're going to sit in a chafing dish. Do we even use those anymore? But with sterno, who remembers sterno? And it's just going to up here. And it's okay to have a little crunchies on the bottom because we're going to make the sauce in here, and that's going to just add to the flavor. Not sure I can fit all these, so I'm going to stop here. And like I said, if you like to be really organized, you can only start like left to right fill in the pan, so you know on the left side they're going to be cooked first, or you know, front to back or whatever. I'm just kind of watching them, and I'll try one here in a minute to see. I try and resist using tongs because you don't want to smush them. So yeah, some kind of a spatula. This one was like the first one I came across in the drawer. Not my favorite. Cheap one I got somewhere. But I like to use my little wooden spatula to kind of help with my left hand. Because contrary to popular belief, I really don't like sticking my hand in frying pans. So as you can see, everything's starting to get a nice color to it. And remember, if one accidentally breaks, it's fair game. You can try it. Sometimes I think I intentionally do that. Alright, let's just get a look at one of these. And if you made these really perfectly round, I'm not sure how you would get them cooked on all sides, but anyway. Oh yeah, they're beautiful. I don't know if you can see, but they got a lot of nice color to them. And it's fine, I do like this recipe, but I'm not a real big fan of all that fussy kind of stuff like cooking these meatballs, but it's worth it. This is exactly why you don't want to have too many in your pan, because you gotta be able to flip them all and get to them all. Now you've got a nice crusty side, you can kind of roll them around a little easier. And it's perfectly fine. Little pieces of the onion are going to fall out. If there was one piece right on the edge, it will fall out. So how do you know when these are done? Well, you're really going to start to see all that pink go away. Yeah, it's going to have good crust on at least two of the sides. I can't figure out how you do all the sides, but you kind of roll them around a little bit. I try not to handle them too much, unless I see one that really looks like it needs a little help. And you don't want to have, I only put like a tablespoon of oil, and I use canola. I think the olive oil is a little too rich for this. I don't want to start with too much because I'm going to make the sauce in here. So you want the juice from the beef more than the cooking oil. I've decided that this wonderful pan I've had for 12 to 15 years, is just not like it used to be, and I'm probably going to need to retire it here soon. So if you have any recommendations, please let me know. Definitely have some meatballs here that are pretty cooked. So I'm going to turn this down a little bit just so I'm not getting all splattered when I'm getting these out. try and get the crusties from the bottom. I'm going to keep those in. Try to make a little room so I get the last of those in here. All I got is a plate with some paper towels just to absorb some of the juice. It's very annoying getting splattered, but I'll live. Make sure these aren't sticking too much. Does smell good, okay? I'm just throwing it out there. Alright, so we finished cooking these up. I'm going to be back in about 2 minutes. I'm going to show you how we're going to make the sauce and get these meatballs all cooked up. And so, give me a chance to clean up a little bit and get everything back when I finish these meatballs up. See you in a minute. Okay, got everything else ready. I'm just getting the last of these meatballs out. This wooden spatula is really handy. I really like it. I think everyone has like their favorite kitchen tools. And you know, it's funny, you find something you really like and you never find it again, so. Okay, so what are we gonna do now? Get rid of this. For starters, don't need this. So what I got is, I got some green onion. And I didn't take as much time as I'd like, but you know, you want those little pieces about that size. And I saw a couple bigger ones in here. Yeah, sorry. It's kind of for looks too, so let's just get these a little cooked. And if any of you are like, you said you don't like green onion, you only use red onion. Sometimes, you know, I want that kind of almost bitterness of a green onion. I mean, I think this is a good time. If you want to be really festive, you could use a little red. I mean, green pepper, sorry. You could use a little red and a little green, you know, so you get the red and green for the holidays. Yeah, green peppers like aren't my favorite. I mean, sometimes like you get go to a good pizza place and their green peppers are okay, and sometimes they're just a little harsh. Not so much. Okay. So these just really take about a minute or so just to but I got me a nice old 14. This is 15 ounces, I don't know why, but can of tomato sauce. So I guess I don't have to get it all out because I really need 14 ounces, right? Just kidding, I don't think an ounce is going to make a difference. Get this up to a nice little, and the tomato's acid, so it's going to deglaze the pan. So I'm going to let it do its thing here. I got a quarter cup of brown sugar. Now, if you know you got a pack brown sugar to measure it, it comes out like a big lump. See a big lump, that means you did it right. It's going to bring that sweetness. It's funny, I went to the store yesterday because I wanted a green pepper that was fresh. Slim Pickens. Must be a green pepper shortage. I don't understand that. But probably could use a little more, a larger one. But it's going to just give some nice flavor. See, is it bubbling? There she blows, it's a bubbling. Wearing a clean shirt, gotta stand back. Alright, kinda get that brown sugar nice and dissolved in. Alright, then I got 3 tablespoons fresh lemon juice. Because we want our sweet and sour, hence sweet and sour meatballs. Okay, once again, we just want to get this nice and heated through. I know this isn't thrilling at this point, but it will be. Now remember, like I said, this is something you can put in a big dish with some toothpicks. You can serve it over rice as a meal. You know, sometimes this is when you're like trying to think of something to feed PE children. This can be something easy to do. I just think it's just something good, and it's easy. You saw there really wasn't a whole lot of prep to this. Target. Hey, now. See if I can do this without totally making a mess. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, whoa, whoa. So we're going to heat these through, give them a chance for that juice to kind of soak in there. So I'm just going to kind of roll these around. If you want, you can take a spoon and kind of keep spooning the sauce on it. Obviously this is kind of the last stage. Trying to think of other things you could do with this. Kind of stumped, but I think it just has a nice presentation if you got people coming over. And you know, I know that people aren't really always good about thinking outside the box, but you know, when you have a little party and you got some hors d'oeuvres and you got some, you know, you got some nice warm stuff and some finger food stuff, and you know, I've certainly put out a lot of recipes that would be good for little parties. You know, don't kill your stuff. There's stuff you can make ahead. You could make this ahead and just heat it up, and heck, that'd probably be better next day anyways. But just keep in mind that, you know, do something fun. Maybe wait until there's a big sale at your favorite discount liquor store and buy a couple bottles of champagne, you know, maybe something a little fun like that. Because let me tell you, believe it or not, two things I've learned. Champagne goes really great with hors d'oeuvres and desserts. You know, there's nothing better than something that's kind of heavy as a dessert, you know, chocolate or you know, something, even something as simple as, why do you think they serve champagne at wedding parties with cutting the cake? It's because you've got all that sweetness, and so you want a nice dry champagne to kind of cut through that. And it just kind of makes you feel like you're fancy, you know? The food can be mediocre, but it just makes it a little fancier. Okay, so I cooked this down, heated it all up. Looks pretty darn good. So I just want to show you what it's going to look like. Yeah. It's all good now. Keeping the sink filled. It's my job, right? Dishwasher put one of my spoons in the wrong place. I had to fix that. Alright, so what we're going to do, we're going to take, and if I had a little rice, I'd put it on it, but I just want to show you what the end result looks like on this. I'm just going to take a couple meatballs. So we got a meatball, we got a green pepper in there. As you can see, it's mighty toasty at this point. Just don't know, you gotta try the green pepper, because you never know, right? It's perfect. It's actually turned out really well. And so you got something nice. Stick some toothpicks in it. Let your guests go to town. So remember, way you do some kind of fun. Like I said, it could be dinner or hors d'oeuvres. Start thinking about that. Maybe you know, invite your neighbors over that you sort of know, or maybe you know them really well. Do something fun and really impress the heck off them, because they'll think, wow, you're an expert. And you'd be like, yes, I am, but that's only because I watch Bill's cooking show. So anyway, I want you to subscribe. I want you to comment. Ring the notification bell and do something so you can have some fun. Don't kill yourself in the kitchen, but just do some fun stuff. Challenge yourself. If you think you're a pretty good cook, try some of the harder recipes. If you're afraid to cook, try some of the simple stuff. You can't go wrong. Okay? So have a great day, and we'll see you next time.